subscribe to James the Sheriff Dixon, you motherfuckers.
All right, listen up. There's a storm coming. A storm the likes of you have never seen before. Now I'm going up there and I'm going to try and stop it. But there's going to be a lot of people down here that are going to need your help. I know you're scared. I'm scared too. They're sharks. They're scary. No one wants to get eaten.
What's going on, guys? James here to bring you another video. And as promised, we are going to be talking about Sharknado 2, titled the second one for this week's Bad Movie Friday. So last week, we did Dracula 3000, which again was a surprise bad movie, but we're not here to talk about that. This is going to be February's first Bad Movie Friday, and I'm going to try to keep posting them weekly as I've been doing like all January. So let's jump right into the IMDb. So I have it written down here. So in IMDb, it has a 4 out of 10 stars, and it came out in 2014. And it was directed by Anthony C. Ferrante, F-E-R-A-N-T-E, and written by Thunder Levin. That's actually what it has written down, T-H-U-N-D-E-R-L-E-V-I-N. All right, and let's go to the budget for the box office. The budget was $1,500,000, and the gross was $114,000. That's the world's gross, which isn't good for, well, a movie. So let's talk about it. So the main guy from the first one came back for this one, Ian Ziger, who played Finn, who was, I didn't mention this in the for the first one, he was my favorite for the first one. He came back, and I liked Vivica Fox's character for this one. She played Sky. That was her character's name. But the story for this one was the storm from the last one picked up from L.A. and traveled along the coast to New York. They're different coasts. I don't know how that happened, but it did. And it got to New York. And there was a lot of famous people that played themselves in this movie. Like, when I watched the credits, I was surprised to find out that a lot of the Today Show people played themselves. Oh, excuse me, played themselves in this movie. So I was surprised about that. Andy Dick was in this movie as a police officer. When I saw him, I was like, that's Andy Dick, which was a nice surprise. There was a lot of famous movie in this movie compared to the first one. So yeah, Tara Reid was in this as well. But yeah, my favorite person in this was the cab driver. I think his name was Martin. No, not Martin. The cab driver. But yeah, my favorite one's the cab driver. I think his name was Martin. His name wasn't Martin. No, I have my notes here. That's why I'm looking at them, and I have the pictures of the actors on the side. No, it wasn't Martin. So my favorite character in this was the cab driver. Who this one was like the other one. A lot of the main characters died, but a lot more lived through it than the first one. So, so the story goes, the guy from the first one, flies out to meet his family, his sister and her kids, and, a storm follows him from LA, so that's pretty much the story. And, he has a girlfriend in this who is a completely different person from the other one. I'll have to go through the other one again to, like, when I make the other Sharknado videos, because, again, I'm going through all of these for this channel. And, to see if Tara Reid was the girlfriend in the first one. But he travels to see his sister and her kids and the husband, who is his best friend. And the storm follows him, and then the chaos ensues. So, that's pretty much the whole movie. I'm going to give my rating here. I agree with it, 4 out of 10, but I go out of the 5-star systems, not the 10-star systems that IMDb does. So 4 out of 5 for this one. I loved it way better than the other one. Remember the other one I talked about, they had like water rising, like the way when the water flooded the streets and like the cars were driving, like one scene the water was right above the cars when the sharks were like swimming around them and they were still driving, and then the next one they looked, there was like no water. They fixed that for this one. I gotta give them props, they fixed it. But again, I loved the cast for this, and it was an okay, decent shark movie. So with that, I will show you the scenes that I have chosen out for this movie, and I will be right back. See y'all in a second.
Where he is nothing. Oh, I've flown worse.
There's something on the wing! Did you see that?
What do you see?
Hang on.
Mr. Shepard, you need to relax. Really. You guys were all just experiencing normal turbulence. There's nothing to worry about.
Next time we're upgraded.
Are you okay, Mr. Shepard?
You need to calm down. Can't have you disturbing the rest of the passengers. You got it?
Up! The hotel's flooded, the water is rising. Why are you going down?
I'm being charged!
Fire escape on the other side.
We can get it open.
Open it with what?
That.
You can't go down there.
Remember those bar fights we used to get into?
Bait and switch. Let's go. Do it.
Let's do it.
No, we're not careful!
Sharks. That was one of the most ridiculous things I've seen in that movie. But again, it was way better acted and directed than the other one, and I love the cast in this. So again, 4 out of 5 stars. And again, I didn't recognize Vivica Fox. She was in that scene. She didn't look anything like her Independence Day character, so I didn't say this earlier, so, but yeah, I didn't recognize her till they said her names in the end credits. So yeah. So these are my final thoughts. I like the second movie better than the first one. And I am planning on doing the third one later on. But with that, let's see what I've got in store for next week's Bad Movie Friday. I'll be right back again, guys.
Father Stewart.
Hello, Douglas.
You're reading, I see.
Yes. A time spent in silent servitude.
A movie called The Velocipaster. So, I'm going to admit something right now. I've already seen it. I watched it ahead of time because as soon as I read this online, I saw this on post on Facebook from a friend. This is one of those good bad movies. It's like up there with The Lost Skeleton of the Cadaver, which is another movie that I did a review on this channel. So The Velocipaster, that's gonna be next week's Bad Movie Friday. So if you want to watch that before the review, you can. So yeah, that's gonna be next week's Bad Movie Friday. So that's the end of this video. With that, this is James saying, if you like what you've been seeing, please like and subscribe for more. This is James saying, peace. I'll let Brendan Rogers take it from here.
Right. I just want to shout out an amazing channel, James the Sheriff Dixon. Oh, he's such a great guy, and he is super cool for coming to the show. I'm glad I got to meet him in person, and you should subscribe.